Hey, what's going on, folks? It's JB here playing the Sentinels. We got the Sentinel Mark V played at 200 points, the Captain America Sentinel played at 400, and we have the Sentinel Mark II played at 300 points.
What's up, guys? This is Adam. I'm playing a X-Men team against the Sentinels. So first starting off, we have Professor X, Cyclops. We have Phoenix, Beast, Storm, Wolverine, Rogue, Gambit. I'm also using a Captain America ID card. And then I also have the Emkron Crystal. And I played the 10 points for the Phoenix Prime to come in. And then I'm also using the X-Men Blue Team ATA.
All right, we got plus 3 for Robot. And here we go.
I got plus 8 since I'm X-Men. I win.
Yeah.
So I will go first. Go ahead and take which side of the map you want to play on.
I guess we'll start on the right side.
All right.
I'll have them all start on top of this, like 7-Eleven or whatever it is.
Cool. Sounds good.
All right. So for the beginning of my turn, I'm going to roll for leadership twice. First is going to be with Cyclops. Did not get it. The second's gonna be for Rogue. And I got it. So technically I get plus 1 everyone's attack values this turn. But I'm not gonna be attacking, so. So at the beginning, first I'm gonna actually. Damn it, this is backwards. I keep fucking up. It was this way. I'm gonna sidestep carry. 1, 2, carrying the professor. And then she's gonna move 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Also carrying Professor Xavier onto the Emkron Crystal. And then it's gonna be placed here. Alright, so next up I'm going to. Carrying Cyclops. Here. Then we'll move Gambit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
The villain's coming down.
9. Move him all the way over there. And then remove Storm. I'm carrying Wolverine. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. And she's gonna carry Wolverine. She'll place Wolverine right here. And then we're gonna move Beast. He's gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, all the way over there.
Storm's gonna perplex up, I guess, Phoenix's defense by 1, and she's gonna use Smoke Cloud as a free action.
Put 1 there. Put 1 under top, or underneath her as well. Here. 1 underneath Professor. And 1 underneath Gambit.
Gambit also picked up the light object on his move action.
So, Sentinels are programmed to attack. So, that's what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and do Running Shot. Has a value of 9. So, 1. 2, 3, 4, 5. So he sits here.
That'd be right there.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, true. The range of 8. I don't think. Yeah. That's not gonna happen. Alright, so we're gonna take that back and we're just gonna actually have the Captain America said I'll move his full value, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There you go. So there. Tokong. And then we're gonna have the Mark II move his full value. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. The Mark V move his full value of 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 5 and conquer. Alright, and that's it. They really don't have anything else special, but yeah.
Alright, so we roll leadership. I'm going to roll leadership for, let's do Rogue first. Negative. I'll roll leadership for Cyclops. Negative. And I might as well do a free action for Phoenix. So I'm going to get plus 2 to all their combat values.
Damn.
Alright. Now what do I want to do? Because now it's dealing out a lot of damage. Alright, so let's do a power action for range of 10, so he's power action for Professor X. I'm gonna drop it on this Sentinel's defense, so he can't use impervious. So I get power action for that. And I'm gonna start off with, she's gonna sidestep 1, 2 around the corner, and she's gonna take a shot. So I get plus 2 to my attack and damage and defense. And before I move, I'm going to perplex up her her damage 1-2 as well. So it's going to be 12.
Sorry. To do 4.
12 against 18 to do 6, because I outwitted your defense.
Yep.
And you get 6. Miss. No prob. Actually, I do have prob. Thinking.
Let's give it to Storm.
Pushing damage. Storm perplex. Alright, second roll. And I got it.
To do 4.
Six. Want me to click it?
Yeah.
Ooh, improves legs. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Yeah, that's my stomach. That's where he was, right?
Yep.
Alright. So. 1. Let's do this. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna do running shot. Trying to take a shot at him. That's it.
So it'll be 11 against 17.
Penetrating second glass. Need 6. I got it. 3?
Yep.
1, 2, 3. Alright, so now I'm gonna come over here and do charge with a beast. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna be pushing him. And I'm going to, might as well blades against this Mark Sentinel.
Be against 17, so it needs 6.
And I missed my 1. Click for that. And I'm going to outwit your, what is your damage power for him?
It's rolling doubles, so if I roll doubles, you get penetrating.
I'll outwit your running shot.
Alright.
And I'm going to outwit your... outwit your perplex on him.
forgot how his power goes. Double perplex or something.
As long as it's within four squares of him.
Oh yeah, that yeah, that special outwit. Gotcha.
With a range of four.
All right, and let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The basic with Wolverine.
I'm going to clear Gambit, and then I'm going to activate Smoke Cloud, but place it in the exact same manner, and then clearing Rogue too. And that's the end of my turn.
All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to opt to use Captain America Sentinel's Energy Whip, and I'm going to use that against Beast.
Oh, shit.
Since he's within four squares. So we will roll a 10 against Beast's 17.
Before damage is dealt, though. So yeah. I still get my 9, or my plus 2.
Oh, plus 2 is... Because
It's before damage is dealt. You're going up against my attack roll. So I don't get super senses or toughness.
So I'll be going up against a 19?
I think it's the same with Wolverine, though, isn't it? And then she has plus 2 is 19 for her too, because she rolled the her special damage power last turn.
I guess I'll go against the Cyclops, because he's within 4, so 10 against 17, so 7 to hit. Boom!
And I'm just going to eat it.
So it'll be for 4.
So go ahead and click them for me.
So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Alright. So
all my powers are countered now.
Just top that.
Alright. What's up? You got my text?
Yeah.
Sentinel's gonna attack Beast, so he's gonna up against 19.
Yep.
So 11 against 19, gotta hit a
8.
Hope I roll doubles.
What's your damage? Oh, that's the doubles, yeah.
Yeah, boom. Alright, good enough. And we're going to charge. It's kind of weird though. Would it work if charge?
Yeah.
And then attack?
That's a good question, actually. Because you ignore the lanes of fire. Where's the. Line fire chart. So great size, lines of fire, smaller characters do not block your line of fire. So that answers our question right there. Where were you at?
Here. So it runs a direct line, but it goes through his square. So I think technically it'd be blocked, right? All right. So we're just going to place him here. But he won't be able to attack because it's out of his range of his charge. So, top him out.
All right.
And
any other free actions you got?
That's it. We'll perplex.
That was the one power.
Oh, yeah. So I got to roll on your turn, right?
Okay. No. That was from a Beast.
Okay. Yeah, so I'll be back to you.
All right.
All right, so we're going to do leadership first with the only person that has it now is Rogue. And now I'm going to do the free action for Phoenix. So nothing. Alright. So let's do this. Let's give... Hmm. Yeah, 17. They're both 17. And they're both... How many points is he? 300?
Mm-hmm.
Or 400. Or 200.
2, 3, 4.
Alright, let's outwit his... Sorry. Power action to outwit his defense with Professor X.
So are you pushing for that?
He has willpower.
Okay, cool.
On his top click. Let's not do that. I'm gonna do something else. I'm actually in mind control. Against the Mark Sentinel. So it's gonna be a 10 against 17, maybe 7. Got it. So I'm just going to do close combat expert against this sentinel. I do everything to... How much damage do I do? Two? Three. I'm going to do one to each. So 11 against 17. So I need a six. Alright. So now I'm going to shoot. Actually, I'm not. I'm going to charge the rogue up to here. I'm going to try to hit. So 11 against 17. You get a six.
Nope.
And I'm going to perplex up his attack. And he's going to use the light object and throw it. Those are all gone as of right now. But I'm going to do the free action after this to put him back in the same spot. So, with Gambit, as Biokinetic charging, I can use super strength, but he can't pick up or hold heavy objects. So when he throws an object, modifies attack value by plus two and increase the damage dealt by two. So I'm gonna do that. And I'm gonna perplex up his attack. So it'll be 13 against 17. I can't use the penetrating psychic blast with that, can I?
Nope. Because you're throwing an object.
For some reason, I thought it was penetrating. But whatever, so it's going to be 1 plus 2, so 3. I'm going to do 1 damage. That sucks. Alright. So 13 against 17. 4 to hit. 4. 1 damage.
Click him.
And I should actually outwit it, everything. I'm gonna outwit your close combat expert, outwit your running shot, and then I'm gonna outwit your perplex again with a beast. Now I'm gonna give Storm a free action, drop a smoke cloud.
And I'm gonna clear her, right?
Yep, I will at the end of the turn. I'm going to do Cyclops is a full blast, so I can just penetrate a psychic blast. So when I do, I ignore blocking terrain and then destroy it, which doesn't do shit. And I'm going to perplex up his own damage to a 3. Oops. So it's going to be 11 against 17. So I need 6. Negative. I'm going to give Wolverine a... Flurry with a Wolverine using blades and precision strike. So here we go. It's going to be 11 against 17.
6.
I got it. Precision strike 4. 1, so it'll be 1 click.
He has toughness, so.
Precision strike.
Oh, okay.
So 1. Second attack. Gonna be 11 against 17. You get 6.
Well, precision strike just you can't be guarantees reduced. The hit. It just you no. can't be reduced below 1. Yeah. Oh, so it's still mm-hmm. yeah, still gotcha.
So second, it's gonna be 6. I got it. Using blades 4, 6. It's gonna be 4, 5. Let's see how these dial is. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so he's gone. So now we place those option tokens.
Alright, so Captain America Sentinel's down, and we place the 4 distinct Ultra Heavies along with the 4 Bystander tokens.
Alright, and then I'm going to clear Phoenix, and she's going to sidestep back over to the Emperor Crystal. I'm going to clear Storm. And I'm going to clear.
So first we're going to start with the Captain America Bystander tokens. We're going to have the left hand do hypersonic and attack Wolverine with the...
We'll go here.
Yeah, yeah.
So you get empowered.
So we're going to get empowered from that, from the right foot. So it's going to be 11 against 19.
Eight.
So I got to hit 8. And
got boom. You want to click them for me? It'll be 4.
3.
So 4.
Oh yeah, 4 with empower. So 1, 2, 3, 4.
It just use these for now, or we'll place it afterwards. So you got one. Or you can do that.
And next, we're going to follow with the right foot, just doing a regular swinging attack. So it's going to be 11 against 16, so 5 to hit. Reroll. Let's reroll the hands.
Ow. All right, so you got toughness, it'll be 4.
2. 2. 1 and 2. On that. And then right hand is hopefully going to lay the smack down with blades. So it's going to be 11 against 15. 4 to hit. Here we go.
Got it.
Got that. We'll roll for blades.
2. For 1. I think he's KO'd though.
Boom. Yep.
Damn.
Out for the count. Action token for the right hand. What we got? End cap. Yes, we'll leave the left foot alone. We'll have the Mark II clear. Actually, we're going to push the Mark II. We're going to push him, so we will do 11 against 19.
Yep.
So 8 to hit. Ooh, and got double, so yeah. That shit's penetrating for a total of 5.
But I rolled out of it. Awesome.
Crazy. Alright, so you don't take any damage whatsoever, even rolling crit, because mm-hmm. That's a guaranteed hit.
Nope.
That really sucks.
Takes 1.
And we'll push the Mark 4. He's going to use this Frigid Beam. So that's basically end cap. I could choose whether to have the person or have the hit character not use any game effect or can't be moved. Or have the hit character receive 2 action tokens. So we'll go ahead and do that. It's going to be 10 against 17. 7 to hit. And miss. So he pushes for that.
Yeah,
so says that. And he's already been clicked.
Right.
And those still stay because I pushed them. And that's it.
Alright. So I do a free action for Rogues for Leadership. Using the ETA. Nothing. And then I'm going to do free action for Jean Grey. So I get -1 to all our combat values this turn. Awesome. Okay. I'm going to use Beast's outwit power. I'm going to outwit your invulnerability and then your running shot. And I'm going to use Steel Energy with Rogue and try to hit. And I'm going to perplex up her defense using Storm, or her defense, her attack. So it's going to be 12 against 17. Hit 5. I got it. 4. So I'm going to take, Steel Energy, so I don't take damage. I do and I don't. And then I'm going to take Close Combat Expert. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So she has Close Combat Expert now. And a range value of 8. Beast is going to just swing. It's going to be 11 against. Sorry. Damn. I have to look at his dial. So there's 16 or 18.
That looks like an 18.
Roll with that. All right. So 11 against 18 is 7 hit. Got it. four, three, so it'll be 4-2 because of toughness. So 1-2. Free action smoke cloud with storm again. Actually, no, I'm not going to do that. Let's get rid of all the smoke clouds. So let's do this. Let's sidestep two over. 1-2. Where was he at? He was right here.
So I want to go to.
And then I'm going to perplex up Gambit's attack value to a 12. He's going to perplex up his own defense one. And Storm's going to... Yeah, might as well take a shot. Actually, I'm going to perplex up her defense by one. Not his own. Storm's going to take a shot. 9 against 18, since he has energy shield deflection. 9. I don't think you take knockback. And I'm gonna give power action to try to pick up the M Crown Crystal. So 4-6. Got it. Phoenix. And I'm gonna clear. Actually, no. Sorry. I didn't attack with him. Yeah, screw it. So he can go down swinging. Just swing at a... Did I attack with him already? Who hit him? I did attack with him already, I'm sorry. Didn't I?
Yeah. Actually...
I did.
Yeah, because that's the only person that I was able to attack him.
Mm-hmm. So let's do this. So let's clear Professor X, and Gambit, and Cyclops. And free action smoke cloud. I'm gonna drop here. 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 And I guess I can still technically put another one. So there. There. And there. And since you occupy a hindering terrain, you get -1 to your attack values. Or the smoke cloud. Attack, clear, attack, roll. So that's it. It's your turn. Alright, so the smoke cloud doesn't work that way. They all have to be within range, so let's do this.
So we're going to take the gamble with the Mark V, and we're going to push him with Colossal Stamina to do regen. So here we go.
2-2.
Not bad, but technically he gets 1.
Why is that?
Because I'm pushing him.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. So 1. And then we'll opt to clear... the Mark II will have the left foot. Just no moving attack on that. That sucks. We'll have the left foot occupy hindering right here.
Okay.
And then we're going to clear the remaining pieces of the Captain America Sentinel.
That's it. All right. Alright, so begin the turn and roll leadership for Rogue for the X-Men ATA. And I think it was 5 or 6, right? Can you see?
Or is it 6? I think so.
Alright, X-Men Blue ATA is... Oh, and successfully used our leadership. Plus 1 done.
Yeah.
Attack value of all characters in this team ability by +1. Okay. Alright, so we're gonna start things off. We're gonna just swing at a... Actually, before I do that, I'm gonna outwit your energy shield deflection, and I'm gonna outwit your defense. I'm gonna push him. Actually, let's not do that yet. Let's shoot with Gambit. And she's gonna perplex up his damage one using penetrating psychic blast. So it's gonna be 12 against 16. I can't see, is that 6? 16. So I need a 4 to hit. And I got it for 4 damage. 1, 2, 3. He's KO'd. Now, I'm going to swing with Beast. What did your defense? It's going to be a 12 against 18. So you need a 6. Missed. I'm going to sidestep up to here. If I can fit him. And she's going to attack. So it's going to be 11 against 18, so I need a 7. Got it, so that'll be for 3. 1, 2, 3. Sidestep 1, 2. Perplex up, I'll do Rogue's defense. He's gonna move. I can't remember if I placed this out or not this turn, so I'm gonna leave that like I did. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Over to here. And I'm gonna give him, or Professor X, a power action. And he's going to outwit your, what's your defense on him? For a mark 2, go see his card. It's on this one right here. So defense by +1 for each previous attack targeting this turn, so that doesn't do anything for me. And I'm gonna do the Hunter Killer. So if you KO, so when Hunter, or when Sentinel Mark II KOs a character after actions resolve, remove an action token from it. If the KO character possesses the Brotherhood Mutants, X-Men, or X-Men team ability, remove all action tokens instead. So I'll out with that. Or actually, you know what, I'll do that. So move action, power action, power action. And clear Storm. And clear Rogue. Last turn, but that's fine. And that's it. It's your turn.
So we're going to have the Mark II attack Beast. It's just going to swing. It's going to be 10 against your 19. You know what? First, we'll do this. We'll have the right hand charge. Little shit. Blades.
Against, who are you attacking?
Against Beast.
Okay.
So it's going to be 11 against your 19. 8 to hit.
Oh, shit.
Fucking right.
All
right,
let's see if I can roll. Nope.
All right.
So, all right, roll your blades. So for 1, since I have a toughness. You
technically
have
3.
Why is that?
Because it's crit.
That's right. So it'll be 2. Yeah. So go and click on 2 for me?
2. Actually, yeah, that's right.
Okay. Did you have any reducers?
No, I did add toughness, but you said 3, so it's right.
All
right,
so good on that. We're going to do hypersonic with the left hand. He'll be sitting here, but I guess he's going to move back down here.
Okay.
Because he has overall movement of 11. So...
are you attacking?
We'll attack Beast. So it's going to be 11 against...
same thing.
19. Jesus.
Eight.
That sucks. And then we'll have the Sentinel attack?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We'll have the Sentinel attack. For that, we'll do a move action here. So we can benefit from Empower. So it's going to be 10 against 19.
Got it.
On the money. So it'll be a total of 4.
Nope.
Sweet.
So it'll be for 3.
So 1, 2, 3.
Oh, yo. How is he still alive?
Yeah, that's pretty fucking nuts. So action token on him. You outwitted the hunter killer thing, right?
Mm-hmm. I lost out with it.
Oh, okay. Well.
So you get to pull off.
If that's the case, then
comes off.
Get to pull it off. And clearing the left foot.
So, begin my turn to roll leadership with Rogue for the ATA, and I got it. So plus 1 to all combat values, or attack
just
values.
Just attack.
Yep, just attack. This turn, with the X-Men keyword. All right, and let's... there's not much I can do. I guess we'll do this. We'll perplex up Rogue's attack to a 12. Let's perplex up Phoenix's attack to an 11. So it'll be plus 2, so it'll be 12. And she's just going to shoot at the Sentinel. So it's going to be 12 against, what's his defense value?
So modify the Sentinel's Mark 2 defense value by plus 1 for each previous attack targeting this. So it'll just be the regular attack, so 16, right?
Yep. So 12 against 16, so yeah. 4 to hit. Four, three. No reducers or anything?
Nope.
1, 2, 3. So you modify his by plus 1 now?
Plus 1, so still rocking a 16.
So let's swing with Rogue.
Rogue.
So she's actually, you know what? I went out of order, that's fine. It's gonna be 12 against 16, so
you're gonna have to move her.
I have a range value of 8, because I hit the Mark 2 until I choose
again. Oh, okay.
Go. I got it. 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now you get... that sucks because I can't get to you. Alright, the Cyclops 1, 2. And then he's gonna move up to here. And he has willpower. He's gonna flex his own defense up 1. Gambit has leap climb. He's going to move to here. And I'm going to give Professor X a power action. Sorry, I pushed into that. There we go. I guess he'll perplex up his own defense 1. Professor X is going to get a power action to use Outwit. He's going to drop that on the Sentinel for out our region. She's gonna just try to hit. Why is that there? Maybe it's 2, I don't know. We'll figure it out here. She's gonna try to hit the left foot. So 9 against 8.
19, because it's in hindering.
I'm just gonna clear. And go to Beast. That's it.
All right, so Mark 2 is going to go ahead and swing at B, so there's going to be a 9 against a 19. So I hit a 10.
And he's dead.
Cool.
I think was in line of fire.
Four.
I think it's minimum range 4, wasn't it?
Minimum, yeah. So he has a range of 6. Square. So place 4 pieces of barrier. Right, meow. And that ends the turn. Oh, with the exception of clearing the left hand also.
Alright.
That's it.
Alright, so gonna roll for Rogue's leadership. Got it, so I get +1 to all their attack values. And now we roll off for the Professor X.
So we both rolled 2d6, and if your result is lower, move the mental lock marker.
So 10. All right, so it stays there. I'm going to perplex that prone attack 1 as well. So now it's going to be an 11. I'm going to shoot at that foot. 11 against,
so you gotta hit 19.
10. 11 against 19.
Yeah, so you gotta hit 10.
8.
Oh.
I have +1 from the ATA.
Okay.
And then prone, perplex.
Oh, okay. So 8.
Nope. Alright. And I'm just gonna clear pretty much everybody else. He's gonna perplex his own defense up. He's gonna perplex his own defense up. He's gonna do shit. I'm gonna perplex down your, it doesn't do anything. Unless you, yeah, it's perplex their own defenses up. I cleared everyone else, so that's the end of my turn. Actually, let's do a free action for my next one. For Phoenix. So nothing. Alright. That's it.
So we're gonna have the right hand do blades.
Against Phoenix?
Yeah, actually. Yeah, we'll do that. So he's gonna move here. So I can benefit from empower. And then we're gonna have the right hand do blades.
Well, the blaze is locked.
Oh, okay. So
you'd be better off not even blading and just taking the 4, because that's still a pretty good damage value. It's up to you.
I'll take a gamble. Could possibly get a 5 or 6. Right. So we're just gonna have the right foot first. Go ahead and shoot at Cyclops.
Alright.
So it's going to be 11 against 17.
17. So I perplex both their defenses up one with their own perplex.
Okay.
So he's 6.
Of course. Then we're going to do blades.
11
so
against.
I hit a 6.
Oh, that sucks. That was a guaranteed hit.
God damn it.
Alright, you still got it. So do your blades. 4. So it was the same result. Just going to clicker for me.
So, 1,
two, three, four.
We'll have the sentinel attack too. Try and hit something with it. Fuck.
Pretty much everyone's.
Yeah, everybody.
We can hit everyone.
Well, yeah, it's all the same value. Alright.
Who are you going against?
Shit. We'll go. What does Phoenix have?
That's a good question. She has Invincible and Regen. So.
Yeah, fuck that. We'll go against Cyclops.
Alright. So 9 against 17. So 8. You got it. So 4. 3. Two. 3. So you got Empower.
Yeah, 3 with Empower.
So go and click a. Should be dead.
1, 2, gone. Clearing the left foot. Over here.
Good.
Alright, so we still got the left hand from Captain America's Sentinel, so we're gonna hypersonic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We'll have the hand actually just end. So 7 there, 8, 9, 10, 11, we'll have an end here. So it's going to attack Xavier.
So 11
so we got 11 against
17.
17, so 6 to hit.
Got it.
Got it.
That was 4, 3.
Our total of 3.
So go ahead and click them for me. Now that's it, right?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. I'm a little off for it. Okay. So, leadership first for Professor X.
Or not Professor X, Rogue.
Did not get. So now we roll off for Professor X's outwit. I hit a whopping 7.
Left-handed.
And
bam.
Got it, so that comes off. And I'm going to give a power action to Phoenix. Bring in
Captain America.
Shit. Where am I gonna put him at? Put him.
Yeah, that's what you Jason.
Yeah, I'm trying to. You have to defend. I want to knock out. Oh, actually, I like, still can. Let's put him there. So I don't have to give me action right away. Alright. So let's do this. Rogue's gonna charge. 1, 2, 3, 4. Over to here. Try to hit the right foot. It's going to be 11 against 18, so I need 7. I got it. This one's gone. There you go. So now I'm going to use Close Combat Expert with
Captain America.
Everything to his attack value. So pretty much, as long as I don't hit a crit miss, because it's 14 against 14, I hit. So no crit miss. Ready for 3.
Right, gone.
1, 2, done. So now it's down to the feet. And it's going to do a close combat attack against the left hand. Perplex up my attack to a 12. It's going to be 12 against 18. Need a 6. Missed. Flex up their own defense 1. Might as well give him a power action now. 2, outwit. Hypersonic speed. Flex, perplex already, attacked, attack power action. So that's everything.
Alright, so since Sentinels are doomed, and Earth is pretty much saved for the most part, we're going to have the right hand go ahead and push. We're going to do blades. Hopefully to get something out of it. Here we go. So it's going to be 11 against a 17.
6.
Clown. Got it. We got that. For blades. Come on, 6.
I'm invincible, so it doesn't do anything.
Wow. Yeah. 6 would have been cool. So off the board. And then we're gonna have the left hand just swing at Gambit. It's gonna be 11 against a 17, 6 to hit.
Got it.
Got it.
4-2, so go ahead and click Gambit for me.
So, 1 and 2, still in the game, very much so. He's out. And we will just have the left foot, which is the last piece, base Charles.
All right, so first things first, I'm going to roll leadership. Nope. I'm going to perplex up Phoenix's attack to an 11, hypersonic speed to a 1 here. It's going to be 11. 11 against 17. So you get 6 to hit. Got it.
And that's a game.
Good game.
All right, good game, sir.
Feminine and handshake. All right.
Yeah, I know. You just grabbed
Let's do it again.
You grabbed my fingers, motherfucker.